Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we'll look at how to name spiro compounds. So spiro compounds are polycyclic compounds that share one carbon atom. So let me draw an example here. Okay, so this carbon atom in the middle there is shared, okay? And that is what makes this a spiro compound. So let's go to the next slide. I'll redraw this and we'll look at how to name it systematically using IUPAC nomenclature. Okay, so for naming spiro compounds, pretty much everything is opposite of what you would do with a bicyclic compound. I think it's probably the case that two people that didn't like each other decided on how to name them and then did it opposite just to spite each other, but that made it hard for all the rest of us. So with a spiro compound, you start in the small ring, so spiro S, small s, and then you start one outside of the shared carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I'm back to this middle shared carbon, that's 5. I can go in either direction. It doesn't matter in this case because I don't have a substituent. We'll look at that next. So this will be 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this is a spirodecane compound. And then I'm going to need a couple of numbers to tell me about the number of carbons outside the shared carbon. So I have on the left-hand side carbons 6 through 10 that are not shared. So I have 5 carbons there. And on the right-hand side, I have carbons 1 through 4 that are not shared. So that's a total of 4 carbons there. So when I name this compound, it's going to be a spiro and then brackets. And then because we're doing spiro, we go small and then big. So opposite what you do with a bicyclic. So 4, 5, end bracket, and then right up against that bracket, decane. So spiro tells me that I have one carbon atom that is shared in my polycyclic system. The 4 and the 5 tell me about the relative ring size for my compound, and then the decane tells me the total number of carbons. So in this case, I have 10 total carbons. All right, so in this example, I have substituents. It is a spiro compound, so I need to start on the smallest ring and one away from the shared carbon, the next door neighbor. I can either start at the top or the bottom. In this case, the bottom carbon has a substituent on it, and I want my substituent to have the lowest number possible within the confines of the way that I must number, starting on the smallest ring. And so I'm going to start down there to give that methyl substituent a 1. So then I would go around the ring, 2, 3, 4. Now that I'm at the shared carbon, I can either go up or I can go down. And so if I go up, I will hit that ethyl substituent sooner, giving it a smaller locant, which is preferable. So I would go up 5, 6, 7, and 8. So this is a spirooctane. My substituents go out in front in alphabetical order, just like for any other naming. So this would be a 5-ethyl-1-methyl spiro, and then I have a bracket, and now I have to see the number of carbons outside of the shared carbon. So I've got carbons 5 through 8 here, so that's a total of 4 carbons outside of the shared carbon on the left hand side, and then I have carbons 1 through 3 on the right hand side, so that's 3 total carbons. Now remember, when we do spiro, we go small and then big, so this would be a 3, 4, and then octane for my total number of carbons. So I have a 5-ethyl-1-methyl-spiro-3,4-octane. All right, so in this last example, let's go the other direction. So we have a name and we're going to draw a compound from it. I'm going to start with my parent molecule, which is a spiro-3,5-nonane. So I have 9 total carbons. I have 1 shared carbon. And so what I can do is I can just add 1 to the number in my brackets to tell me how big that ring is. So if it's sharing only 1 carbon, then this ring must be 4 members, and then this ring must be 6 members. So that makes it a little easier when we're sketching the whole thing out. So I'd like to draw them sort of sideways so that I can connect through that spiro compound. So there's a 4-membered ring. And there's a 6-membered ring. And it doesn't matter if they're on the right or the left-hand side, because by convention, you would still always name the same way. You would number around the smallest compound first. So let's number this. Remember, we start on the smallest ring, and we start next door to the shared carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so that's good. I've got 9 total carbons, and I have 3 past the shared one on the left-hand side and 5 on the right-hand side, so I'm good there. So now all I have to do is put my substituents in. So the bromo is at the 2 position. I've labeled this position 2, so bromine would go there. And my iodine is at the 6th position. Let me get this out of the way here so we can put our iodine in. So I would put my iodine right here. So this is 2-bromo-6-iodo-spiro-3-5-nonane. So you can go from a structure to a name or from a name to a structure. So that is how you name and draw spiro compounds. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.